And fresh on the heels of the last episode, this is more like Crusader. I'm at 30 life. I'd better do something about that. Luckily, I have several provisions. An abundance of food and beverage to fill me and hydrate me. Yeah, I'm recording this right after the last video. I usually record a couple of them at a time and then space them out so I have an update every day. Although I haven't been good about the whole updating every day thing lately. It's because I've been doing, you know, I had the screenshot when I was doing and I've been messing around with subtitles and really time-consuming stuff. Which really isn't really an excuse because, I mean, videos like these, pretty easy to do. I mean, it doesn't take me much longer than the time it takes you to watch the video to do it. There's almost no post-processing. All I have to do is convert it to a file size that YouTube can handle, but I can just do that at work the next day. So yeah, even when I'm not running an LP on something awful, or if I'm running a screenshot LP or something, I want to try to keep one on YouTube too, so I have something to update with every day. Because I know that for some reason a lot of you guys seem to enjoy watching what I do. So, yeah. And plus I have fun doing these. I have a lot more fun doing these than I do the screenshot ones. I mean, don't get me wrong, I enjoy doing the screenshot ones. It's just, like I said, a lot more work and a lot more time consuming. Okay, I was hoping to get this one, since that's what I thought it was pointing at. I don't know, I might have been off by a little bit. Try it again. Okay, this is the street level, and with any luck, it'll be between the other two levels that we've already done, if that theory is sound. With this, you just have to hit the last lamppost that lights up. Deceptively easy. And there are zombies stalking the streets, but we have magic to take care of that. And another black potion. I know better than to drink that. I'll probably end up selling it eventually.
I'm melting. Melting.
I don't know why they thought these puzzles would be difficult. Did they think people were trying to play Simon with them, or... Come to think of it, I don't remember how quickly I figured that one out. I might have tried to play Simon with it at first, but... I mean, they just go too quickly. And this wasn't much of a level. I haven't actually read this guy's dialogue yet, so... I am one of King Garriott's wizards. Those who are planning the revival of the evil demon have imprisoned us in the Eight Worlds. So if you help the eight of us who are imprisoned, we'll help you defeat the Man of Darkness. Okay, well, maybe there's some solidity to this pointing theory after all. Okay, yeah, I've already been here, because it was pointing up. I think Ramiah was the demon's name in the version of the game that I have. Ramiah, Ramo, something like that. I'm not sure why they changed it. Well, I know why they changed it from Huster, because Huster is a really stupid name. And this is a slip-slidey kind of level. Let's see. Not entirely sure. Okay, I know. I remember. It's been a while, but... You have to have all three of these spherical units touching so that they don't go sliding across the ice until you're ready to push it upwards. And it will... It's supposed to hold that button down, but things don't always work out the way they're supposed to. So yeah, as I was saying, As I was saying the other night, Retronauts. The most recent episode is about an hour and a half long, and the format of it is they spend about half an hour or so, 20 minutes, half an hour, talking about retro news, which is like releases on the Wii Virtual Console, re-releases of classic games, stuff like that. And then they have one topic that... One topic that they talk about for, you know, however long it takes. And the topic of the most recent episode was Chrono Trigger, which, you know, anybody who's ever played who likes RPGs at all is going to say it's one of, if not their favorite RPG. It's just an amazing game, and they do a pretty good job of discussing it. They talk about a lot of the history and who worked on the game and stuff like that, and it's pretty interesting. The only problem I have with Retronauts is that the updates are very sporadic. This is the first update that they've had in a couple months, so. But I mean, it was a real treat for me. I don't listen to many podcasts. It's like Retronauts and the Penny Arcade one, where they talk about where they get their ideas and stuff like that. Well, not where they get their ideas, but they basically go through the process of drawing a comic strip in the course of the podcast. So, and that one hardly updates either. Sometimes I listen to This Week in Tech, and I'm usually, I find I'm not interested in the topics they're talking about. I mean, I'm interested in technology, gadgets, you know, stuff like that, but can I hit these things, or do I have to use magic on them? No, I can hit them. They're just tough. But yeah, I don't know, something about the format. I think they have too many people talking, and it makes it difficult to follow all of the threads of conversation and stuff like that. Or maybe, I don't know, maybe it is the topics they talk about. Wow, I forgot about that. When you kill these elements, they explode in whatever element they are. I don't know why magic's attacking me. I thought magic was my friend. It's a lot of fire. So, just wind and earth left. We're pending for a bending. Come down here. Let me take a whack at you. Pending for a bending. See, it works on two levels. It's both a Futurama reference and an Avatar reference. This guy again. I already killed you. Did you not die well enough the first time? Did I not do a good enough job? Let me use magic against this guy. Fudge that. Oh, a wise guy, huh? So yeah, apparently yesterday was Halloween. Well, technically yesterday, it feels like today for me. I didn't do anything. I just went to work, as usual. No costumes. No fun for me. I should probably be playing a Halloween-themed game, or horror-themed game or something. But I figure that's what I accomplished with Splatterhouse. Especially the last episode. That last episode was really horrifying. Okay, that's four down, four more to go. Hopefully we'll tackle a couple on the next episode. This is Duke of the Bump, and I will see you guys later.